I upgraded my game to Godot 4, and by upgraded, I mean started building my game again in Godot 4. Did I have to start again? Arguably not, but I decided to use the migration as a total cleanse of not just the code, but also the whole project structure. Depending on how far you are into building your own game, you may be looking on with horror, but I can honestly say I'm really happy that I went down this path. And I will say that I didn't redo most of the art, so it's not like I was starting from total scratch. Okay, let's talk a little bit about Godot 4. Godot 4 isn't even in release candidate stage yet, but since it started a regular beta release cadence, it's been mostly stable. The Godot team and all of the contributors are doing a fantastic job. So let's rewind back to Godot 4 Alpha 14. Before jumping into rewriting my game for Godot 4, I had to make sure that my add-ons would work. My game doesn't use any third-party add-ons, so I just had to update mine and I'd be golden. The first one was my smallest one, Input Helper. That was an easy one. Next up was a big one, Dialog Manager. For Dialog Manager, I decided to take the same approach as my game, a total rewrite. I had a big list of stuff I wanted to do with it, but those would be breaking changes. Major version changes are when you want to do that, so it was the best time to do all of the things. It was a great opportunity to get a bunch of experience with the new syntax that came with GDScript 2. And boom, Dialog Manager was version 2. Next was Puzzle Dependencies, my add-on for managing puzzle dependency charts. It was simpler than Dialog Manager because it doesn't really do much more than provide a nice interface for managing a graph edit component. And lastly was Sound Manager. It was simple, just a few rename methods and it was done too. Now, I was finally in a position that I could start the rebuild of the game itself. I came up with a couple of rules for keeping the new project structure clean. Number 1, keep dependencies close. Any sprites, sounds, scripts or whatever that relate to a scene should live in the same folder. Number 2, export external dependencies where possible. This is an alternative to hard-coded path strings. Using exports means that when the target is moved around the file system, the dependency reference is updated automatically. And one more rule, which is more of a guideline, is stuff should be found where I would first look for it. This is more about the general folder structure. Everything should fit with one of these top-level folders. Characters in characters, custom nodes and things in helpers, interface stuff in interface, localization stuff in L10N, music in music, actual game scenes and locations in scenes, and object and tile sets in world. Okay, let's fast forward to now. I have most of the project back up and running with a few improvements, but also a few things missing. In general, I'm happy with how a lot of the code is structured. I've abstracted a bunch of stuff into reusable base classes, as well as given everything a custom icon so my scene tree looks more colorful. I know icons were already possible in Godot 3, but I didn't bother to do it until now. I've also added this atmosphere property to location scenes that adds a shader depending on the lighting conditions. In sunshine, for example, it adds a subtle orange-blue gradient and a slight bloom around the edges of the screen. I've simplified my water and lava shaders so that they use less code and, for the lava shader, actually look more like lava should. And I have to say, I really like the new tileset editor. It makes adding stuff like trees, rocks, and even the water a lot easier. I've redrawn my tavern tile set to more closely match the perspective of the exterior tiles. The main thing that's still missing is combat. Coco can attack, but there's nothing to attack just yet. Now that Godot 4 has a better navigation system, I'll be reworking how my enemy behaviors work. So combat is next on my list, and that's all I have for now. As always, if you have a question, then drop a comment below or jump into my Discord for a chat. I'll see you there, or I'll see you here again soon. Bye.